Hello, friends. Today's story is called King Hezekiah and the Sundial. King Hezekiah was a good king who did all he could to encourage people to obey God. One day, King Hezekiah was feeling very ill. He lay in bed wondering whether he would ever get well again. He had a very nasty boil full of infection. People came to wish him well and show their sympathy. "Get well soon," they said. "Sorry to hear about your illness." As the days went by, the king became weaker and weaker. Soon the infection was so bad that everyone thought he would die. Then Isaiah, a prophet of the one true God, came to visit King Hezekiah. When Isaiah walked in, the king brightened up. "Perhaps the prophet has some good news for me," he thought. But Isaiah had some very bad news for the king. "It's time to put your affairs in order," he said. "You will not recover. You are going to die." The king was devastated by this news. He turned his face to the wall and started to pray, very sadly, to the Lord he loved and trusted. "Lord, remember that I have obeyed you faithfully and served you with all my heart. I tried to be a good king," he wept. "I've tried to obey you. Please don't let me die." And Hezekiah continued to weep bitterly. As the king lay crying on his bed, Isaiah was walking out of the palace when suddenly the Lord called out to him, "Go back to the king. I have heard the king's prayers and have seen his tears. In 3 days' time, I will make him better." Isaiah rushed to tell the king the good news. "God has heard your prayers, and in 3 days' time, you will be well enough to go up to the temple. God is going to add 15 years to your life. He will also protect this city from our enemies, the mighty Assyrian army." King Hezekiah was delighted. But then he became full of doubts. "Can the Lord give me a sign to show me he really will do what he says?" he asked Isaiah. Now, in those days, people told the time by using a sundial. As the sun moved across the sky from east to west, it cast a shadow. And as the sun only moved across the sky in one direction, the shadow would only go in the same direction, day after day. "Yes," said Isaiah, "God will make the shadow on your sundial move 10 steps. Should the shadow go forward 10 steps, or should it go back 10 steps? It is a simple matter for the shadow to go forward 10 steps," said Hezekiah. "Rather, let it go back 10 steps." The king sent servants to watch the sundial. To their amazement, they saw the shadow move backwards around the edge by 10 steps. It went the wrong way. When the king heard what had happened, he lay back with a sigh of relief. If God could make time go backwards, then he was sure God would heal him and add 15 years to his life. Isaiah ordered that some figs be mashed up and placed on the king's boil to help it heal. And sure enough, 3 days later, Hezekiah was out of bed and feeling great. Now, we don't know how God did this, but he is the creator of everything. And he can do the impossible. Hezekiah recovered and lived for another 15 years, just as God had promised. So here's what I want you to remember this week. King Hezekiah's story helps us to appreciate that every day we live is a gift from God. So every day we should give thanks and praise to God for our lives. Everything we have comes from him. Our memory verse for this week is this: "Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Psalm 136, verse 1.